Hey guys, this is Ashish for WP Xbox. Today we have Xbox game for review, and it's called as Battleblock Theater. It's kind of game which resembles Mario, where you have all power ups and you have discs to throw and kill enemies. This kind of stuff. So it's a single player, multiplayer both, but there's no queen here to rescue. And there's a guy who has friends around, but those have been captured by someone, and he has to play levels, collect gems, and then and then free up his friend. So what you're seeing right now is a multiplayer option, or at least a co-op, you can say, if you're playing with two guys on the same network or on the same console. So you go on the maps and capture gems and create restore points, kill some cats. Now the cats are enemies here, and you have powers, then you have icy flows, and then you have boats where you can use to cross the river, and these are like bombshells. When you touch them, it blows them off. Now there's multiplayer online game available also, but I cannot show you because I couldn't manage one to play when I was recording. Now these are the couple of options you get when you play Battleblock Theater. So you have a console base, Xbox Live, and you can actually go and create the game levels also if you don't like. And then you have achievements, then you have letterboards and all those stuff. The graphics are pretty amazing, keeping in mind. So you have story mode and the arena mode, and then you have normal mode and pretty insane mode. So let me show you the arena mode on the console one. I mean, it's kind of like stories you get to play. So that's kind of story you get. Make sure you keep saving your game. The game costs like 400 Microsoft points, which is almost like $10, and pretty good game to pay for. It's worth actually paying. So you get into a jail kind of place where all your friends are captured, and you get inside, and you have then couple of chapters coming up. I'm not sure how many chapters are there. Now all those signs which you see as green tick marks, these are already I have played in, and the one which is red, there's something left, you need to do something more in that, and there'll be something which is locked also. And the one you saw on the left with the cat is actually the bigger level. So I'll play one level here. You need to collect gems, then you need to come here and then do that. That's actually scene 2, and there will be moment when you're playing the game when it will be difficult for you to find out how you pass through the clouds. Like you see the clouds above, you actually can pass through some and you cannot pass through. I had a big hard time to cross that, so you need to jump, and you can actually double jump. So you press the A twice and you can double jump. So that's kind of tricky sometimes, but you can get through it. And those are the cats, you need to blow them up, and that's actually how you blow them off. You push them towards the laser, and then there are boats which you need to pull, and you actually need to use RT. So half the time was sitting on the boat and then pressing RT, but that's not how you should do it. So you need to press RT, and then you pull the boat, drop the boat, and then you go ahead. Overall, the graphics are pretty cool, though it's a 2D graphics, but it's very well done. I mean, there's no problem or there's no glitches in that. You can very well play with them, there's no problem. And it's not necessary to kill all the cats, because you have a lot more to do. And this is an amazing part, like, when it touches them, this blow off, and you have on the top the igneous rocks, which you can see, they like shoot you in one direction. So it's like, now watch out the next what I do, that will be fast. You jump in, grab it, jump again because you have a laser, and then you move up, and then you need to catch the stairs and move up. So that was very fast. These are the icy flows, so which just slip and they push you towards water. So there you go, that's how you get into a water. So if you cannot get through, you might have to find out another path to get inside it. So go inside, get out, and it pulls you back. So you need to be very, very quick. So this game actually needs you to be very, very quick and respond very fast. And these are rocks, which is water we need. So, you know, you need to run. You need to actually run very fast to get the... And so, you know, you gotta be a bit careful here. And then I'll show you how to double jump this. You need to press A and keep on moving forward. So you cannot take risk of, you know, missing one of the jumps, else you will fall in the water again. So I'm almost done here. There are only a couple of steps. And remember, all what I'm showing you is kind of edited. You know, I didn't play all of these in one shot, like two, three times. So, yeah. So you will face this. Now, the one you are seeing on hanging on the top are actually the ones you have collected. So they're thread balls, they're gems, and the more you collect them, the more points you get that you can use to, you know, free up your friends. There you go. This is one to keep you busy for some time. So, you know, you need to be changing your direction that you reach the level. So this level is complete and you get a couple of coins and all those stuff. And this is something different from other games. They put in marks and you get to see what levels you have completed. So you have an idea what levels you do. So thanks for watching the video and I hope you like the game and you're going to buy it and play around with your friends. Though the multiplayer is pretty awesome, you won't find a lot of people, so that's kind of drawback. Thanks for watching.